name is Ahmed Orisha Nafalabi. I'm a teacher in Nigeria Korean Model School, and I'll be speaking on the topic multimedia content development and computer literacy. Before we talk about multimedia content development, there has to be a knowledge of computer literacy. And what is computer literacy? Let's start from the word literacy. Usually, we usually think literacy is a stage of not knowing how to read, right, to a stage of what? Writing or reading in any form of language. But I think literacy is now beyond reading, writing. It's also, could be also likened to what? Knowledge acquired over time in a certain field. So what is computer literacy? Computer literacy could mean different things to different people. Literacy could mean one who could read, write in any native language. Hence, computer literacy could be defined as knowledge and ability to utilize computers and related technology efficiently. I want to talk about computer literacy. Like it was defined here, any knowledge acquired related to computer or its technology involving application installation, manipulation of several aspects of computer, that could be linking towards what we call computer literacy. Now, it could also refer to how comfortable one could use computer programs and other applications that are associated with what, with computer. There are so many things. When we talk about computer, it goes beyond that thing, either laptop, desktop. We're talking about the internet part of it, the application in it, the installed and uninstalled ones. So we have so many various aspects of computer literacy. We have one we call fundamental. Nice. One we call fundamental. Fundamentals, which will also involve, let's say, components of computer. Talk about components of computers, usage of keyboard, mouse usage, operating system navigation, printer usage, saving, opening and deleting files, internet usage. They are part of what we call the fundamental aspect of computer literacy. That is, before you could say, you could say anything about computer literacy, that is, you know how to own a computer, shut down a computer, do some one or two things on computer as regards opening the document, locating a document or a file on the computer, connecting your computer to internet, and so on and so forth. We also have one called intermediate. And under this one, we also have one called advanced. Now I want to talk about intermediate. This one involves backing up data, that is saving on another, either in the cloud, saving a hard disk and all that. Installing and removing software. You see that it goes beyond just mere typing, using PowerPoint, browsing, talking about maybe on the software that are not properly installed in a laptop or in a system. You want to uninstall them, or you want to put in a new software that you want to be using. We have so many applications depending on your field. For example, you're in architecture now, you want to install AutoCAD. As a teacher, there are so many games you want to install on your laptop. It's also, this stage is what we call intermediate stage, social networking and etc. Now we'll talk about advanced stage. This stage is where user not only use it for its own, his or her own purpose, but for the purpose of other people. For example, computer programming. Now, we are talking based on education environment. Now, there are some educational games you want to develop, educational application you want to develop. At this stage, you are not a programmer. You have moved from fundamentals, just mere using how somebody, program somebody produced or provided. You are now at this stage of providing programs for people to use and solve their basic problems. You also have what we call computer scripting, called game designs, computer repairs and troubleshootings. Maybe during the course of computer usage, at this stage, you could troubleshoot a computer. Maybe it's giving you a problem, it's not coming up. And in case of any eventualities, that stage is what we call advanced stage, called online collaboration and etc. Now, having done all these things, then you cannot say you are what? Computer literate. And that is one benefit. One, computer literacy helps you what to save time in most of the things you want to do. For example, as a teacher now, you want to draw, instead of you draw using a cardboard to draw, you could as well get some of those images on computer, go online, get all those images. Also, it helps in independent learning. For example, as a teacher, for you to be able to search for some content for learners, you could also go online. Even for learners also, you could also go give them a video, they will study on their own at their own pace. It also gives accuracy and it helps in work performance. Now, with this now, we can now move to what we call multimedia content development, having gotten the whole or partial knowledge of computer literacy. Now, what is content development? Teaching and learning processes have been greatly influenced by innovation, evaluation of computer, network, and multimedia technologies. Now, this is 21st century. When we talk about education now, you see we are talking about involvement of computer in it, technology, educational technology materials, and all that. And so many methods has also been influenced as a result of advent of computer in education. Also, these technologies allow teachers to properly plan on content delivery, influence active participation of what of learners. This content development over time has also what been carried along students or learners in the class, and it also make work to be very easy for teachers. They also add interest to curriculum and its delivery. It's not like normal, usual, traditional method of teaching. A teacher goes to the class, start writing, write learners copy notes and all that. It has moved beyond that. So now what is multimedia? You can say it brings dynamism also to content delivery. You also bring dynamism to it. So we talk about multimedia and its elements. Some of the elements of multimedia content development are what? Text, graphics, animation, audio, and what? And video. Now, this will now lead us to what we call content development, because the aforementioned elements are just things that make up multimedia. Now, what is content development? It's researching, organizing, producing certain information to meet a set objective. When developing multimedia, consideration should be given to how technology can be used to acquire, organize, demonstrate, and communicate information. That is what we call content development, because we are using technology to gather information, to organize information, to present information in a way that it won't bring ambiguity or make passing a vague statement to learners or to targeted audience. Now, the planning process for multimedia content development is also similar to planning a normal lesson. It's also the same method, only that mode of delivery and mode of preparation just light between two of them. The main difference is how the learner acquired the knowledge and skills, because it's still the same lesson you are writing on your notes, in your notebook, is still the same way you are writing on the board, only that the way they are acquiring it or the way we are presenting it. Now, we have various steps that could be considered in multimedia world content development. This element, they are very, very essential in planning content development using multimedia. One, check the curriculum content. It's also very important. What you want to pass out to a learner or to set of learners, very, very important. That will also prompt how you plan content development. For example, you select a topic as part of the unit. You want your learner to know how to solve, for example, now word problem in mathematics from a given topic, because there's always a word problem after every topic in math. Now, because I want to, as a math teacher, I want to deal with word problem now in my class, I must be conscious, okay, this is different from solving geometry. So the type of content development I'm going to plan using multimedia definitely is going to be different, because in geometry, I have to use more of shapes, diagrams, drawings, and all that. But in word problem, there could just be some specific words which I have to highlight for the learners to really understand the word problem itself. Also, you have to also know what is called learning objectives. What are the things you want to really achieve? For example, what you want to achieve for GS1 under the same topic might be different from what I want to achieve for GS2 and GS3 thereabout. Now, always, for example, now in word problem, you must use letter to represent sentences. Also, establish relationship between addition, subtraction, and what? And multiplication and other operations in mathematics. So they are also very, very important. Now, in planning multimedia content development, time of delivery or time allocated for that particular lesson is also very essential. So I will not just be writing and, for example, coming to a class, you want to show a video, there must be time limit for such a video. You must also be a time for evaluation. All these various aspects of lesson delivery must also be put into consideration. Now, determine knowledge and skills. First, you must know what the child or the learner knows about that topic, one. Two, also about computer. For example, some set of learners might not really understand what we talk about multimedia. First, as a teacher, maybe at a leisure time, you must be able to put them through so that they familiarize themselves with multimedia elements or technologies. So they also need basic computer skills, which is also very, very essential. Very, very essential in planning multimedia. So when you are trying to present a multimedia to set of learners, we should also make sure that they also have knowledge of it, so that what you are saying will not be carried away by the graphics, the pictures and some colors and all that, but the content or the main information you are trying to pass across. Now, this also lead us to what we call, which medium do you want to use to teach? We have several media of teaching. We have either through online videos, PowerPoint presentation in class, personal video recording. Just like we have several methods of, for example, we have blended learning. Under blended learning, we have almost 6 models in which you can use to go about this blended learning. We have what we call flip learning, in which you give your learner videos or whatsoever for them to go home, and they come back the second day, you do revision in class. So this medium is also very, very essential in planning content development. And also, as we have said, linking it with the topic earlier, also very, very essential. So as in planning, what's it called, blended multimedia content development, you have to put medium of delivery. Also, when you talk about the major method of delivering content, is usually using PowerPoint presentation. One, slide content, very, very essential. You have 40 minutes and you are trying to present something to your learners, and you are just preparing slides, 20 slides, 30 slides, without knowing how many minutes that must be spent on the slide. It's also very, very essential in multimedia content development. So at the end of the day, you end up just, maybe you have 20 slides and you are just at the end of your lesson, you are only able to execute only 10 slides. So very essential. So also, spelling check must also be done, because this pupil or the learner, they write everything down. So we must check your spelling. Also, sometimes it's always good that after writing everything in multimedia, it's better we give to our colleagues to check for us. We can also go through them several times. So, okay, ask a colleague, check this in for me, especially for spelling errors. Maybe what you have done has meet up the learning objective. Also, do at least practice lesson to check timing and flow. It's good to check time flow on each slide. The number of hours or minutes or seconds spent on the slide, very, very essential. Also, slide sorter view, also very, very essential. Also, you must have, in planning multimedia content development, it is all very good to also plan for what? Plan B, contingency. For example, after you must have prepared your slide, videos, well arranged, there could be technical issues in class, and that might disorganize the whole plan. So, in planning multimedia content development, it is also very essential to have plan B or mode of delivery. Also, mode of assessment is also very, very important. One, determine the method of assessment. This multimedia will foster how we assess this child. Sometimes you could also send assessment through online, or you could choose to do them in class, or you could ask them to do it depending on number of computer or number of systems available. You could also give them to try it on system. So mode of assessment is also very, very critical. So set the criteria to evaluate the technology product with a focus upon content is also very, very essential. So for example, now, like I want to solve word problem, I have one example, I'll just read it out. In a flying race, the second leg is twice as long as the first leg. The total distance for both legs is 297. How long is the first leg? How long is the first leg from this race? Now, so many people will see this like it's so ambiguous. There's nothing like mathematical operations. There are some basic points in trying to use multimedia to solve this. There are some basic points to note. First, we have some operations. We have in a flying race the second leg, which is unknown. What are the critical things here? Now we have what we call twice. Twice. We have what we call twice. Now, in trying to do this now, as a teacher using multimedia, I have to highlight this twice in my example for the learners to know that twice is also very, very important. We talk about total. Total. Multimedia will help you to be able to highlight the essential one and also give other meanings to this. And in trying to solve this particular word problem, this will help us to, all these ones will help us to be able to give students focus on what to focus on. Also, we have what's called in a plan, the first leg, which is what? The first leg. Considering this example, in a flying race, the second leg is twice as long as the first leg. If the total distance for both legs is 297 kilometers, how long is the first leg in the race? Now, we might not solve it, but I will just give illustration on how to identify basic information from this word problem so that it will help us to form equation that will make it easy for us to solve. So let's bring out the information. Now, from this question now, twice is very important. Total, very important. Now, we talk about first leg, second leg. Now, first, as in planning content development, this particular information is very, very important. Twice. Also, total, very, very, very important. First and second leg, also very, very important. Now, let me go back to the question. He said, in a flying race, the second leg is twice as long as the first leg. If you understand this particular information, it is very, very important to solve the whole question. For example, you can say, let the first leg be what? Let the first leg be x. Be what? Be x. Now, they now said, the second leg is twice as long as what? As the first leg. It means the second leg will be what? 2x. They now said the total for both legs is what? 297 kilometers. It means second leg, the total, which means what? It could be sum, it could be, they can say is. So the total is what? You can now say 2 plus x equal to what? 297 kilometer. Now, from this word, in teaching a word problem, it might look difficult for learners to get. But as a teacher in planning content development, immediately you highlight these ones. It could be with color that is meant from other text. It could be with the way you bold it, the font size you use for this particular one. We help learners to be able to cite the critical information, to be able to search for them in this problem, and with that you'll be able to bring out this word, summarize the whole thing into what, into equation. And this is very, very simple to solve. From here now, we now have what we call 3x is equal to what? 297 kilometer. Then they divide it by x, we now have divide by 3, and this will give the needed answer. I hope with this one you have gotten a little insight into multimedia content development. Thank you very much.